he has motivated us to write paper in the transactions. And later on, we find a publication in that journal. So we are very thankful for that motivation. And now I have to introduce him. Dr. Nishal Verma is an associate professor in the Department of Electrical Engineering, IIT Kanpur. He obtained his PhD in Electrical Engineering from IIT Delhi. He is an awardee of Devendra Shukla Young Faculty Research Fellowship by IIT Kanpur, India for year 2013-16. His research interests include intelligent fault diagnosis systems, prognosis and health management, big data analysis, deep learning of neural and fuzzy networks, machine learning algorithms, computational intelligence, computer vision and image processing, and many more. He authored more than 170 research papers. Dr. Verma is a fellow of IETE. He is currently serving as an editor of IETE Technical Review Journal. He is an associate editor of the IEEE Computational Intelligence Magazine, an associate editor of the Transactions of the Institute of Measurement and Control, UK, and editorial board member for several journals and conferences. So I invite him with a share, Main kahan rukta hoon, arsh o farsh ki awaaz se, mujhe jana hai bahut uncha hadhe parwaaz se.
Don't expect any self from my side. I normally am very bad, you know.
We expect a very good talk.
But anyway, thank you very much for a very nice introduction. Okay, so we are here for this talk on deep learning and computational intelligence. So before we go to deep learning, let us first understand what is learning and why do we at all require learning, right? So may I know how many of you understand why do we need to learn ourselves first and then the system? Why do we learn? Why do we learn? Why do we try to learn?
To get a better understanding of our surroundings and how.
Very good.
To perform better in the future. Not in present, learn from the present and to get better results in the future.
So learning does what?
To be able to make decisions.
Learning is able to probably classify, make decisions, right?
So the new task.
Learning means getting experience and experience comes from bad experience. So learning.
I'm going to ask you another question. Probably that will make you understand learning better. So all of you are intelligent. Is that right or not? Yes. Everyone is intelligent. But the level of intelligence in everyone is different, right? So, what decides intelligence?
Application of that intelligence is solving a new task.
Application of?
That intelligence, how we handle it.
No. What is intelligence? I mean, why do we say that somebody is more intelligent than me, I am more intelligent than somebody else?
The way one analyzes a problem and solves it.
It is the ability to cope with the uncertainties in the coming environment, or you have to tackle those uncertainties or that is not already experienced by that person. You have to formulate, you have to be to so
very intelligent. Long answer, it is very difficult. But anyway, that's a good try. Very good. So what I understand and what in general is that this the performance, the learning performance, right? the capability of learning, you know, that is measure of intelligence. Is that right or not? If somebody learns very fast, is more intelligent. Can we say like that?
Yeah.
So let us understand that much. I agree with your answers, right? But let us now understand this much only and proceed to understand further the learning of systems, right? So we are more intelligent because we can learn efficiently, right? The level of learning, level of intelligence, they are analogous, okay? The same is true with the systems, right? So I can say I am more intelligent if I am able to learn faster. And we will relate this with the artificial systems, okay? So now we know what is learning, what is deep learning. Let us now understand that. And before that, I would like to go through the deep learning is a buzzword these days. Everyone talks about deep learning, right? You may have come across these words. Let us now first understand from where it has come and how it has started. Before that, this deep learning, basically it comes in MIT Technology Review, where they published 10 breakthrough technologies, right, in 2013. I remember when I was starting machine learning, I was entering into machine learning, doing some work in computational intelligence, and this term was not at all, that was there, but it was not like as now we are getting it. So in 2013 MIT Technology Review, that time also it came, but if we see in India, this was not there, right? Let us now see what Google search tells us, right? So in Google, right, if we see the trend, deep learning was there right from 1960s. If we search, we find literatures, right? So from 1960 onwards, the computational intelligence, if we talk about, because one of the constituents, agent, is neural network. It is started in 1943. Okay, so we can say computational intelligence, because computational intelligence also is a new word, right? It has started coming into being after 2003. So this deep learning, if we see, it existed in the literature, this term existed, and it came off and on, and then finally, if you see here, after 2000, right, it is growing. This plot is till 2009 or so, but otherwise, if you see, it is growing exponentially. Okay, if we see this plot, what do we see here? If this is the plot of the deep learning, right, blue, and machine learning is also existed, it is existing, but it is at higher order, right, higher level than the deep learning. But now it has crossed, or if not crossed, then it has come up to the level of the deep learning. The machine learning, right? So these two words now are being sometimes, you see, interchangeably being used. We have got few quotes here, so if you want, you can go through. Andrew Ng, you may be aware, is a professor in Stanford, and he is a key member of Baidu. You know Baidu? What is Baidu? Baidu is Google of China.
Chinese.
So, He published a paper on deep learning. Basically, he suggested the strategy of learning. Deep learning was existing right from 1965. Right? I will tell you in coming slides. Okay. And more importantly, if you search some Google projects, they involved deep learning terms, you know, in most of their projects, right? So that's not new. But deep learning, basically, this word is popular after 2006 more and more, and it is exponentially growing. So now can we, when you know deep learning, can we know what is deep learning? What do you understand by deep learning? Just guess. I mean, I don't expect the right answer, but I just would like to know what you understand by deep learning. I hope not like going deep and then learning, right?
Learning hierarchical manner.
Hierarchical manner. Very good. You are very close. Very
so maybe learn complex features of a system.
Right.
Learning complex features of magnanimous data in efficient manner.
So can we say deep learning is a learning after learning or intense learning? Can we say?
Yes.
Because as you were saying, it learns, you know, in hierarchical manner, right? So hierarchical manner means you first learn and then you again learn. It's like function of function. So, yes, you are right. So, deep learning is nothing but it is learning after learning in a hierarchical manner. That's it. And deep learning is a separate entity. It has nothing to do with computational intelligence. I will tell you that also. So, if you use deep learning on neural network, it becomes DNN. Deep neural network, right? Or whatever. I mean, there are so many neural networks, the categories of neural networks under this deep learning. So we'll see that also. So let us see what kind of learning is there when we have non-living beings after living beings, right? So learning results basically what? Intelligence, as we just saw. Natural intelligence, we have biological neurons and the same kind of things are happening. So, right from childhood, right, we keep learning and then finally we attain some intelligence. Right? And everyone's capability of learning is different, so intelligence also differs. Natural intelligence, it not necessarily is it present in the human beings. Even animals also, right? But the level of learning, level of intelligence is different. They also mimic sometimes. You can see some of the images where just to give you some idea. And then now let us see in non-living beings, right? In natural intelligence that we have, that is natural, and we have biological neurons and we are able to learn and then we are able to attain the intelligence. In non-living beings, like you have, you develop models and you want those models to be intelligent. Why do you want your models to be intelligent? Because you want them to perform the task that you assign and the way you want them to manage. Okay, you would have seen this kind of thing on TV. Right. So let us now first start with a basic unit. Right. Here, I believe not everyone is from computer science. I would like to bring everyone to the same platform before we move forward. So we'll take only 5 to 10 minutes to bring you to that level where you understand other things. Alright, so here is the biological neuron, a single, you know, the unit, where we have dendrites which takes inputs, and you see here the cell body, and finally, you know, through axon you get the output. And billions of neurons are connected, interconnected together to perform certain tasks. Through the signals that receive and then propagate. Here is the mathematical model of a single neuron. So we call this as the artificial neuron. Right? And those of you who have already done is fine, but those of you who probably have not gone through a neural network can very well understand here that similar to this, here is the cell body where we have the activation function, right? And you see the inputs are coming from the dendrites here. Dendrites is the input nodes, and the output here is the exon. Here is this output exon, right? I mean the output node, and finally you get the output based on the input and the activation function that you choose. I hope this is fine with everyone. So what do we get basically if we have a single neuron? Okay, we have a single neuron, we have these inputs and these are the weights. So this is nothing but the summer here, and this is bias, and this is the activation function through which the summation of all the inputs, right? The linear combination of all the inputs, right? You get some output. And this output is nothing but what? Sorry. This output is nothing but this. Z is here, so this output is sigma of Z, where Z is this. I hope all of you agree. Okay? So this is very simple, model of a mathematical model of a neuron. This is called a artificial neuron. Artificial, the mathematical model of a neuron. Okay. Now you can, this is a single neuron, the one unit. You can have a network. You can interconnect so many neurons, and you can get structure something like this. Okay. So you can have either a CISO system or MESO system or NEMO system. NEMO means multiple input and multiple output. MESO means multiple input or single output. So depending upon your requirement, you can interconnect and you can manage. Finally, you get what you want. This you would have already seen. This kind of neural. This since we have so many neurons, artificial neurons interconnected, forming a network. This is popularly known as ANN, artificial neural network. So, the first layer here through which the input goes in is the input layer, and then middle layer, and here you see the output node through which you get the, you receive the output in the output layer. I hope this is fine. Here you see deep means many. So a neural network, artificial neural network, everybody knows. And you would have seen so many hidden layers coming in between the input layer and the output layer. So I will come to this deep later, but for a moment I will tell you that normally this hidden layer, the number of hidden layers, normally they decide whether the network is a normal network or a deep network. Right? Deep network normally is considered when you have the hidden layers more than two. But not necessarily. This is just a convention. Right? Many of the network will find that even 3-4 layers, but they are not deep. They are not. So, but nowadays, deep we consider when the hidden number of hidden layers are more than two. So, deep would actually deep here would make difference in the kind of learning that you perform with the network, right? So that basically makes the difference. So this two layers, more than two layers, or something like that,
will not only make a difference. Right? So when you say deep network, deep neural network, it means you have to perform a different strategy for learning. If you are not doing that, it means that doesn't come under that category. So why do we say deep after more than, more than two? Because normally when we have more than two layers, this deep learning strategy works better. And this is different than the backpropagation strategy, which normally is being used for general networks, normal neural networks. I hope you agree with this. So, what I mean to say here is that even if you have 3-4 hidden layers, you can perform the backpropagation learning, right? You can learn your network through backpropagation network, but you are not going to get a very good, very successful model, right? Means you are not going to obtain an efficient model. But when you have more than two hidden layers, if you perform deep learning strategy, you are going to get definitely a very efficient neural network. Right? So that is why this difference is being made here. All right. So let us first understand. These few slides are for those who are very new to neural networks. And then when you come up to that level, then you would understand better. So those who are working in neural network already, they may know these slides. So if we have these neurons, these are basically the nodes, and these nodes in a network, they are artificial neuron. So if you have a neuron, right, whether are you going to get this output? Can you just find it out? Just check whether are you going to get this? Your input is 1 and minus 1. Bias is 1 and 0. So you can check you are going to get this if you have a sigmoid function. Okay? So you are going to get the output of this node 0.98, 0.18, like that. And if you further keep going, and finally you are going to get this. Okay? This is all right. If I change the input set, your outputs are different, and the activation function remains the same. So essentially, what are you going to get here? This is a MIMO system, right? So what are you going to get? You are given two inputs here, right? Two real inputs, and you are going to get the two outputs, right? So can you say we are getting this thing? This will be the function of this. Can we say like this? Okay. Similarly, when we change the input, we have this thing, right? As we have seen. Okay. So this is for those who have already who are not very much conversant with neural network, right? So can we say we can obtain the same thing by doing this thing? You can check that, you will be getting the same thing, right? So can we also say, I'm going quickly, right? Can we write the same thing? We take a general network, and then can we write that the output of this node, or this node is going to be this much, the function of this? Yes. Here also yes, here also yes, right? So either way you can manage, right? See, finally if you want to get this output, you can accordingly compute. And there is another way to compute it, right? Either this way. So this is another way, you can parallelly compute all of these outputs at every level, and then finally you can combine them. There is another layer called decision layer, right? Normally that layer is a softmax layer. This is nothing but the classifier, right? So You can have any kind of classifier, either support vector machine or any other classifier, whatever you want. You can put as the last layer, right? So here we have the soft max layer, right? So and this the output is the normalized one. So basically gives the probability, and accordingly you can manage to know what is the output that you are going to get. Finally, what is the decision that you are going to get? You can see here, like this. So I hope that this is normalized, so the total every time you want to get as 1. So if we have this kind of arrangement, our simple classifier is ready. If we have, let's say if you want to classify the numerals, right, here is the image, and if we have the pixel values, this is 16 cross 16 matrix, basically that if we want to supply the pixel values as the inputs, so we have how many inputs here? 256. And if we supply here, and finally we train this network in such a way that train means we develop the network in such a way that it gives or it classifies, right, so that we get the numerals classified. So if we give 2, so for 2 you get to see, if it is trained like this, you get the maximum weight, maximum value, right, the output. And if you see, it is going to say that this whatever input that you have fed is equivalent to 2, or this is for 2, like that. So this is what basically, normally, this is a very basic level neural network. And how do you train that? You use back propagation algorithm for training the simple network. Back propagation, basically you take the gradient and then you propagate the, based on the error, you accordingly, you know, propagate towards from the last layer to the first layer, like that. So you can accordingly manage. But what is the problem here? Problem is, how do you initiate the training? How do you choose the weights? Random, right? So for the same input, if your weights are changing, your outputs will also be changing. Okay? So that is why many a times the number of iterations are also changing. Number one. Number two, the final outcome, right? You might think that you are landing in a global minima side, right? Or maxima side. But that is not the case. You may land up in a local minima or maxima, right? So like that, here the problem in back propagation is because you randomly initialize the parameters. So that problem comes into picture. And every time when you run your code by initializing randomly, you are going to land up in a different situation. So you normally do not know whether are you going to get better results or not, right? So that is the main issue. So here are the limitations. So this is what is with normal learning. I have not discussed deep learning through any network here so far, right? We will be moving towards that. So the limitations of neural network, normal neural network, basically is because of the training. No matter how many layers you can increase, right? But the problem comes when you are going to train the network. You can have so many layers, nobody is going to stop, right? But up to one or two layer back propagation works fine. But when you move forward with more number of layers, this back propagation is useless. It is not going to help you anymore. Okay. So high cost, it is because each neuron in the neural network can be considered as a logistic regression, and the training, the entire neural network is to train all the interconnected So this is one problem. Another problem is it is difficult to train, right? As the number of hidden layers increases.